Hi, it's Carrie. In today's 5-Minute Friday, I'm going to show you how you can consistently and appropriately apply age range limits to your systematic or otherwise comprehensive search. We cannot rely on database filters. And bear with me, it's a little complicated to explain. We're going to use PubMed as an example because that's where it matters the most, but it matters in other platforms as well. So I will start just by building what I consider to be a fairly comprehensive search, not totally systematic, but in the interest of time, we will go to the Mesh database and I will build a search on cystic fibrosis. I'll select the medical subject heading. I always like to show you how I search. I don't think you can ever get enough practice. I added the medical subject heading and I will look at the entry terms to see if there is anything here I should include as keywords. So we will do cystic fibrosis as a text word. So now we have the subject heading or the text word. We will add mucoviscidosis. And what was that other one I saw? Pancreas fibrocystic disease. I'll just add pancreas fibrocystic. That should return it. We will click Search PubMed. 56,048 results, but that's just our first concept. We will go back to the home page so that we can navigate back to the medical subject heading database. And I want to look for a relatively new drug called Trikafta. Now, Trikafta is a trio of drugs, and we see them here in the entry terms. So I'm going to add this supplementary concept. I'm going to add Trikafta, and I'm going to add the other terms here. And I'll click search. That's our second concept. You can see in a platform of 34 million records, we're only getting about 1,100, so it's not a huge topic. We'll go to advanced, and this is where we can combine the two searches. We will say add query, that's cystic fibrosis, and the second concept, add with and. So we're looking for literature that has both cystic fibrosis and one of these drug terms. We'll click search, and we start to see the results, 1,087 results. Something I forgot to do that I really like is to log in. Let me log in. When you log in, your search terms are highlighted, and I just find that to be so much easier on my eyes. Let's take a look at the first one here. It looks like it's from August 2022. We'll just look at the whole record. We've got the title, the abstract, plain language summary, which you don't see very often. And it's so new that it doesn't have any mesh terms yet. So medical subject headings have not been applied, or maybe they never will be. It depends. You know, in PubMed, there's Medline. Those records get indexed with mesh, medical subject headings. There's PMC, those records don't get indexed with mesh. There's the NCBI bookshelf, I don't believe those are indexed with mesh. And then there are just brand new articles that haven't been indexed yet that are in process. So when we build our searches, we include mesh terms, we also include keyword terms so that we can catch everything, regardless of whether it's been indexed or not. And that is true of using the age filters. So if we were to use the age filters that show up down here on the left-hand side, let's say I were interested in this topic in children, birth to 18 years, I can select that and I get 271 results. And let me show you what happens. This is an umbrella term for all of these narrower terms, infant, child, infant, newborn, and preschool. And I think there's more. Oh, here's adolescent. And you have to select them. Because child is the umbrella term for the narrower terms, adolescent, newborn, infant, preschool, child, our number of results didn't change. We still have 271 results. Now, this is only limiting to things that have been indexed with medical subject headings. Let me show you. You'll look at number one, and we'll scroll down. And we see there are mesh terms here. So we see cystic fibrosis, drug therapy, and we see child. So we've already just limited to child just by selecting those filters. I can show you a more sensitive and better and more reliable way to search for age ranges. And this is true of whether you were looking for children, young adults, middle-aged, aged, elderly, it's true in any case. So what we're going to do is clear this filter. We'll go back to our 1,087 results. We'll go back to PubMed, and we'll go back to the MeSH database. Our best practice search should include medical subject headings. So I'm going to look for child, and we will go in here to child. Let's just go up to age groups because I think I'm missing adolescent somehow. Here's what I need. So I want child, comma preschool, infant, comma newborn, and adolescent. And I'm just going to have to type it. Oops. I'll just do it from here. Child MeSH or child, comma preschool, MeSH or infant, MeSH or infant, comma newborn, MeSH or adolescent, MeSH. Let me open this in a new tab and we'll just see what terms are under this one. You can type those in the interest of time, 5 minute Friday. I'm going to not type those in, but we would add other infant terms, or we can just say we're going to add our keyword terms now. Infant, toddler, newborn. Okay, we'll move up the scale here. We'll go to youth, pediatric, both spellings. We'll do child, adolescent. And it's up to you if you like to truncate in systematic reviews or not. It depends. I'm doing a little bit of a rush here. We will do young. We will do kid, kids, boy, boys, teen, teens, teenager. All right, that feels a little better to me. So let's search PubMed. And we got 5.3 million results. Now, we are ready to run it together with our previous two concepts. Make sure that our filters are not clicked down here. We don't want any of that messing up our search results. We'll go to advanced. We're starting from scratch here. We're going to choose cystic fibrosis, add query. We're going to add Trikafta. It's number two, add query, add with and. Now, instead of limiting to anything with MeSH, we're going to add with and our third concept, child, etc. We'll click search, and we should get more than 271, which is what I think we got with the first search. And these look pretty relevant, don't they? Let's go into the history under advanced. Yeah, we got 271 when we applied the database limits, which were limited to subject headings, medical subject headings. And when we built our own search, we got 380. Now, if you wanted to see the difference, you can click the larger search, add query, and you can add the smaller search with not. So these are articles you would have missed had you not built your own search filter for children. Let's click search. There's 109 articles we would have missed. They look relatively relevant. And the reason I would have missed these is because they are not indexed with medical subject headings. So here we have, or perhaps they don't even have an abstract, as we see in this case. So this one does not have a very good abstract, does not have medical subject headings, so we would have missed it entirely. And we won't know if it meets our inclusion criteria until we look at the full article. And so that is why I always advise people, and in my own searching, build your own searches for age groups. Do not rely on these. They're not reliable. They're not translatable. They're going to miss things. And so that was well over 5 minutes, but I hope it helped you. If you're searching for age groups in literature, good luck. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.